The marathon meet between the RBI and the government is over. There seems to be some sort of truce with both the parties agreeing to settle for a middle ground. One bone of contention has been the RBI's prompt corrective action framework. The government had demanded easier PCA norms, and for now, Board for Financial Supervision of the RBI will review the norms. Let's do a three-point analysis on whether the system is ready to relax the PCA norms. 1. What is prompt corrective action? Well, 11 out of 21 listed banks in the country are under the PCA framework of the RBI. Large quantum of bad loans, weak capital levels and low return on assets have been the key reasons behind their inclusion in this club. Government has found an investor for IDBI Bank, and a merger of Dena Bank with Bank of Baroda and Vijaya Bank is on the cards. The fate of the rest is still unclear. If we look at the capital position, even after the latest round of recapitalization, it remains close to the threshold for PCA. 2. How bad is the bad asset picture? Well, none of the 11 banks are out of the PCA threshold, which is net NPA below 6%. Although there is high provision against bad assets, the pace of resolution is slow. The profitability picture is dismal too. From FY16 onwards, these banks as a group have reported a net loss every single year. While the FY16 and FY17, 2 out of 11 banks had reported profits weighed down by bad asset recognition, in FY18, none of them have reported profits. The aggregate loss in FY18 was in excess of 49,000 crore rupees. Now, in the period between FY15 to FY18, the 11 PCA banks as a group have not even shown any growth in deposits. 3. Does the system warrant incremental lending by PCA banks? Well, conventional wisdom suggests that such a push will lead to further upwards pressure on interest rates. A relaxation in PCA norms at this stage will only prompt these banks to take exposure to low-quality credit, thereby exacerbating the problem. Now, such lending would warrant more capital and could lead to resurfacing of the bad asset problem in future. Lending, at the end of the day, should be a commercial decision and is a sole prerogative of the individual entities. It is better left the way it is and in the broader interest of the system.